What's up, guys? Welcome to Kisi Unlocked. My name is Drake, and I'm here to guide you through the world of access control. Let's get into it. Today, we will talk about the Power over Ethernet two-wire extender, its benefits, and the installation process. This is a Power over Ethernet two-wire extender. This device gives power and internet connection to the Kisi Reader Pro 2. It has two components, a PSE and a PD. The PSE takes an input of power and standard Ethernet. It then converts this to a form that can be sent over a twisted pair wire. The PD then takes the input of the twisted pair and outputs a single power over Ethernet cable that connects to the Kisi Reader Pro 2. The Kisi Reader Pro 2 requires power and a network connection to operate. It can get power from an external power source or power over Ethernet, and network connection from either Wi-Fi or Ethernet. By using power over Ethernet, only a single cable is needed to operate the reader. However, power over Ethernet cables are expensive, limited in length, and aren't found everywhere. A power over Ethernet two-wire extender solves these problems. This device can be used anywhere with basic Ethernet and power wiring. It combines and converts these sources to be sent over a single twisted pair wire. This wiring is much cheaper and can be run for long distances. With this extender, the Kisi Reader Pro 2 is powered and given network connection by a single cable. There is no need to worry about Wi-Fi or an external power source. This can be installed almost anywhere, since it only needs power and basic Ethernet wiring. Unlike power over Ethernet cables, twisted pair wires can be run over a long distance. They are also far cheaper and take up a lot less space. For this installation, you will need a Kisi Reader Pro 2, a power over Ethernet two-wire extender, two Ethernet cables, and a twisted pair wire. Flip the switch on the PD component to S and the PSE component to M. Connect the Kisi Reader Pro 2 to an Ethernet cable. Ensure this cable is PoE compatible. Connect the other end of the cable to the PD component, and then connect the PD component to the two-wire twisted pair. Connect the other end of the pair to the PSE component. Finally, connect the PSE component to a network-connected Ethernet cable and to a power source. If you found this video helpful, be sure to leave a like down below. Smash that subscribe button and ring the notification bell to stay up to date on the latest in access control and physical security. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and we'll try our best to get back to you. Thanks for watching.